Uganda Cranes head coach Mitchell Sredojevic is confident for maximum points tomorrow when Uganda Cranes welcomes Niger at St. Mary's Stadium in Chitende. Fahad Bai was part of today's final training session for Uganda Cranes this morning at St. Mary's Stadium in Chitende despite missing out on Algeria's first match away in Algiers over the weekend. Mitchell confessed missing the studded striker in Uganda Cranes 2-0 loss against Algeria on Saturday night due to passports issue that are expected to be resolved by the immigration office before Niger game tomorrow.
Fahad Bayo has the problem with the passport, has nothing with me. Fahad Bayo is like my son. This morning I have escorted him to go to get a passport and he's in contention for tomorrow. However, it's very unfair that in Masterpiece, Ugandan Masterpiece of constructing the stories and the teams, if you go in that direction, they have absolutely top-class relation with each and every player.
Despite several Uganda football fans attacking Mia Farouk for missing Uganda Cranes' penalty, Mitchell still trusts the club less striker to take control of Uganda Cranes' penalties if he's on the field of play.
If it comes on Wednesday, we shall decide as a team. But one thing is for sure, if Carlo Ancelotti could trust Benzema, he has missed more than five penalties during the La Liga and whatsoever, I don't think why us to not do the same and give to me and trusting God wishes if we get.
In the evening, Niger national football team have had a feel of the stadium as they target to get maximum points after drawing 1-1 with Tanzania over the weekend. The stadium hosts tomorrow Africa Cup of Nations 2023 qualifiers has been renovated to international standards by its proprietor, Dr. Lawrence Mulindwa. The 25,000 stadium is now officially an all-seater stadium with spacious dressing rooms renovated to match the FIFA-required international standard. Uganda's victory against Niger tomorrow will take the Uganda Cranes to 3 points in Group F of the AFCON 2023 qualification. Report compiled by Peter Kanyike for the news.